Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for August the 18th of 2020, well, it is titled TYC 8998-760-1, Multiple Planets Around a Sun-like Star. So what do we see here? Well, this is actually an image of a star system showing a star towards the center, the kind of odd looking object. And that's not that that's the star, it's that it has been removed. The star has actually been digitally removed to get rid of its brightness so that fainter objects like the planets can be seen. Now, one of the difficulties in being able to see planets around another star is that the planets are so much fainter. So they only reflect light of their star, so they're much harder to see and they're overwhelmed by the glare of the star itself. However, you can also subtract out the image of the star from multiple images and average it out so you can vastly dim it. And that's where we get some of the artifacts around the star here, the kind of ring patterns that we see. But it does allow us to see these two planets as well. Now, we found a lot of planets out in the universe now, and even just 30 years ago, we knew of essentially very few, just a handful. And now we have thousands, several thousand that are known, and they've been found by a couple of different methods, including how their gravity tugs on the star and causes it to wobble slightly, or if they happen to pass directly in the front of the star and cause it to eclipse. So we use those we call indirect methods to be able to identify planets. This is important because it is a direct observation of this. We're actually seeing the planets themselves, and that's something that we don't often see when you hear about other planets that are discovered. For the most part, they are inferred from other observations. Here we can actually see them, and that takes up objects that are far enough away from their star and bright enough to be able to be seen. So these are actually large planets like Jupiter and Saturn, and actually orbiting further away from their star than Jupiter and Saturn do from our own sun. And that allows us to be able to see them. There could be other planets closer to this star, but they're still too close and too hard to be able to pick out of the noise. So a small Earth-like planet here, for example, would be much, much closer to the star, and we'd still be buried in the noise around the star itself and impossible to see. Although that is something that hopefully we can improve over the coming years to be able to finally detect those types of objects as well. So this is one of the things in searching for something that has changed over the last few decades is how many planets we know of out in the universe. And it has also changed our understanding of how planets form and how solar systems form. When a lot of the ideas were developed many decades ago, we only had one solar system that we knew of, and we would figure that ours is typical. However, we now see that there are lots of other types of objects out there as well, including things like hot Jupiter planets, very large planets that orbit close to their star, something that doesn't exist in our solar system. We also find a lot of planets in between the sizes from in our solar system, things we call super Earths or mini Neptunes. So planets between the size of the Earth and Neptune that do not exist again in our solar system. We have the very small planets close to the sun and the very large planets far away, but there's nothing in between in terms of sizes in our solar system. So the more solar systems we get, the better statistics we'd be able to get to be able to study and learn about solar system formation. So that was our picture of the day for August the 18th of 2020. It was titled TYC 8998-760-1, Multiple Planets Around a Sun-like Star. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Sunspin. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.